Our guest performers are Sophia Rozzi, fourth grader from All Saints at Virginia, Jake Hawes, editor Francis Church, Bryton Albright is our narrator.
In 1897, Dr. Philip O'Hanlon was asked by his 8-year-old daughter, Virginia, whether Santa Claus really existed. She had begun to doubt. Dr. O'Hanlon suggested that Virginia send her question to the New York Sun newspaper. The response written by editor Francis Church has since become history's most reprinted newspaper editorial, appearing in part or whole in dozens of languages, in books, movies, and other editorials, and now in song as well. Join the LHS choirs as we return to the 19th century, where we find Virginia writing her now famous letter to the editor.
Dear editor, I am 8 years old. Some of my little friends say there is no Santa Claus. Papa says if you see it in the sun, it's so. Please tell me the truth. Is there a Santa Claus? Virginia O'Hanlon, 115 West 95th Street.
Virginia, your little friends are wrong. They have been affected by the skepticism of a skeptical age. They do not believe except what they see. They think that nothing can be which is not comprehensible by their little minds. All minds, Virginia, whether they be men's or children's, are little. In this great universe of ours, man is a mere insect, an ant in his intellect, as compared with the boundless world about him, as measured by the intelligence capable of grasping the whole of truth and knowledge. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. He exists as certainly as love and generosity and devotion exist. And you know that they abound and give to your life its highest beauty and joy. Alas, how dreary would be the world if there were no Santa Claus. It would be as dreary as if there were no Virginias. There would be no childlike faith then, no poetry, no romance to make tolerable this existence. We should have no enjoyment except in sense and sight. The eternal light with which childhood fills the world would be extinguished. Not believe in Santa Claus? You might as well not believe in fairies. You might get your papa to hire a man to watch in all the chimneys on Christmas Eve to catch Santa Claus. But even if they did not see Santa Claus coming down, what would that prove? Nobody sees Santa Claus, but that is no sign that there is no Santa Claus. The most real things in the world are those that neither children nor men can see. Did you ever see fairies dancing on the lawn? Of course not, but that's no proof that they are not there. Nobody can conceive or imagine all the wonders that are unseen and unseeable in this world. You may tear apart the baby's rattle and see what makes the noise inside. But there is a veil covering the unseen world which not the strongest man, nor even the united strength of all the strongest men that ever lived, could tear apart. Only faith, fancy, poetry, love, romance can push aside that curtain and view and picture the supernal beauty and glory beyond. Is it all real? Virginia, in all this world, there is nothing else real and abiding. No Santa Claus? Thank God he lives and he lives forever. 1,000 years from now, Virginia, nay, 10,000 years from now, he will continue to make glad the heart of childhood.